So I did New Year's Eve in Dallas this year with my friend Felicia. But tonight was kind of crazy. First of all, Dallas men, white specifically, love the chocolate. Let me just tell you. I don't know if it's because it was New Year's and they were a little drunk. They were all about the chocolate. Okay, that's number one. Number two, then this fool jumps in our Uber, has a knot on the side of his head, looking like this right here. Clearly got in a fight. Don't know what happened. He didn't know either. He was talking as if he had taken ecstasy, cocaine, was drunk, meth, I don't know, all these drugs combined because he was making absolutely no sense. Our Uber driver was a little frustrated with him because he didn't know where to take him. He's asking to go to Arlington, which is 30 minutes away. Doesn't have a phone suddenly, which we saw him use earlier, and then suddenly the phone disappeared. And he's like pulling out all his pockets, couldn't find his phone. He gave some address. Lord knows whose address that is. I pray it's his mama's address and not like an ex-girlfriend's or something, because it's 3 o'clock in the morning, and for him to show up at some random person's house at 3 o'clock in the morning is gonna be a problem. I don't know how he's gonna pay the Uber driver, because when he pulled out his money, he had all of $2 to his name and to credit cards. So I'm gonna say a prayer for Muhammad tonight. That's the Uber driver's name, because I don't know if he's gonna get that boy home or not. We weren't concerned because we got out the car with quickness. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna pray for you. I hope you get him home. Happy New Year! That's all I gotta say about that. I don't know. I don't know. Like, why do people let themselves get that drunk? Why would you let a friend get that drunk? Where was your friend? Where was your cousin? Where was your brother? They were supposed to be looking out for you, but clearly they didn't. You got left by yourself, ended up in an Uber with two random girls. Felicia knows. She was back there with him with this big old knot on his head. Like, what kind of nonsense was this man talking?
Literally, I still don't understand that word he just said.
He was talking about basically killing people. Apparently, he's a hitman. He's like, I can call Pookie and them, and I can take y'all out at any minute. Then Muhammad got crunk, right? He was like, hey, yo, bro, you need to calm down and sit back. I was like, oh, Muhammad got crunk. Then naturally, I forgot Lola today. Of all the days to leave Lola sitting right there. You see Lola? Left her. Clearly needed her tonight because he was acting like he was about to get all kinds of crunk. Where did they do that at? It's 2017. It's new beginnings. You know what I'm saying? We're supposed to do better.
And you were talking about new beginnings in the car. He's like, well, how can we be better? And he's like, he was not actually not making any sense.
It made no sense at all. I was like, what's your new resolution? I mean, I want a girl. And I want a relationship where.
I want to fall in love, but no girl wants to deal with me. And we're like, probably because you're insane and you're talking about like calling people to like kill people
And you, because you got this big old knot on your head. That's
That
why.
too. Yeah, that's not very helpful.
And he was like, Dre. Who is Dre?
We still don't
Was
understand
Dre his
this.
brother?
I don't know. That guy did not look like his brother. The only guy
Oh,
that.
you saw a guy.
No, I think it's like that random dude who was like trying to figure out who our friend was.
The random white dude?
No, not the white dude. The white dude that was feeling you, girl, stop.
Oh, girl,
No.
Brayden
The
was all
black.
up in this chocolate.
No, like the chocolate dude who was trying to figure out who we were, who
The
Benny
African
was.
dude?
Yes. I think
That
that was
they
his
were
friend.
together?
I think that was his friend.
Well, let me tell you, this African dude left him high and dry. Let him get in an Uber with two random girls and lost him forever. We don't know where this child is going to end up. What was his name? Did he tell you? We're just gonna call him Pookie. Pookie with a knot on his head. We don't know what's gonna happen to Pookie. Let's pray for Pookie, y'all. Can we have a moment of silence for Pookie? All right, we're done. 2017, New Year's Eve, Dallas, out. So I have come to the conclusion that men do not know how to talk to women. So we're in this bar. This guy sits down and he asked a legitimate question about our drink. And it was like a mimosa or whatever. And so he's like, oh, you know, how much was that? Is it better to get the glass or to get the pitcher? So we tell him. So then he turns back around. He's like, oh, you know, what'd you guys do? How was your New Year's? And we're like, it's good. No, did he ask where we're from? He asked if we were from here. And we're like, no, we live in Houston. And he's like, oh, I'm from Arkansas. Proceeds to tell us about Arkansas as if we cared. But anyways, proceeds to tell us about Arkansas. Turns back around. His next question after that is, do you have kids?
I thought I had heard him
Where did you
say
do
that?
You just said, where are y'all from? Oh, Houston, okay, I'm from Arkansas. You know, Arkansas is not as podunk as people say. Pause, pause. So do y'all have kids?
I thought I heard him wrong.
Why is that a follow-up question? It wasn't like, so do you guys like Houston, or do you prefer Dallas, or what brought you to Houston, or where are you guys from originally? Oh, that's cool. No, it's do you have kids?
Come to find out, this Negro is only 22 years
old. He's a child. Like, why are you concerned whether or not we have children? Like, you're a child. So, I'm just trying to figure out, like, why that was the follow-up question. Like, logically, why? I'm just really confused. So I've come to the conclusion that men do not know how to carry on a conversation with females. It's
quite sad. When you think
I mean, that shouldn't even be something that comes up for a long time.
Well, he did try to start selling himself to you later. Now that he knows
then,
that we're
talking. Right. Then he's like, oh, so he wants to tell me his whole life aspirations about what he wants to do. Again, I didn't ask. And he's like, oh, that's, I want to do this. And like a rant for 5 minutes. My eyes glazed over. I stopped listening when the first word that came out of his mouth, because I just wasn't interested. And I'm like, you know, and then she's over here being super friendly and keeps nodding and like she's paying attention. And I'm over here like, can you someone save me? Like, I just want to leave. But she's like, that's great. No, why are you contributing and encouraging him to continue this conversation? Like, I don't understand.
Because you have to teach them while they're young. You know,
I should have taught him and said, you know what, wasn't an appropriate question was for you to ask us if we had children. I would have rather been like, so do you have pets? Over, do you have children? Like, so you're assuming. I don't understand why that was even a thought in his mind. Like, I don't know.
Maybe he was really trying to hit you up and wanted to, like, make sure you didn't have baggage. I mean, he would have been your baggage. But that's not the point.
22-year-old baggage. You can't even rent a car. Barely could get an alcoholic beverage. Like, you have no reason to be talking.
I love how that's, like, your cutoff.
Because.
Can they rent a car?
You are not a full adult until you can rent a car without an extra charge. You know what I mean? Your life is not complete until you can rent from Avis, you know?
I mean, they're 25. They're still too young. They're born in the 90s. I can't even deal.
Right. That's another thing. If you weren't, like, legitimately alive in the 90s, like, you can't talk to me. Like, if you were still running around in diapers in the 90s, like, no. You don't even know about the 90s. Like, if you can't name off and ramble off some 90s music, TV shows, no.
I mean, my cutoff is if you don't know Doug. You don't know anything about Patty Mayonnaise? I can't be messing
you
with
know you. What? There's not even just that. Like, if you don't know about, like, Recess. Y'all remember that show?
It's a good one.
Our Real Monsters.
Good one. Mm-hmm. Rocko's Modern Life.
Wait, what was the one with the football head and Olga?
Oh, Hey Arnold.
Girl, Hey Arnold. If you don't know nothing about Hey Arnold, you cannot talk to me. That's my cutoff. Who's Arnold? And if you can't name all of Arnold's friends, Gerald and them, don't talk to me. It's over. It's a done deal. Anyways, mess. We about to drive.
Mess.
To my satisfaction.